So this is our another video to configure the advanced console system ACS 8000 series. So there is a basic step. If you are configuring the EvoSend, so you can see the image here, and if you are configuring it console in device to configure the static IP and gateway, means use one of the supplied RJ45 cable adapter, connect a terminal or workstation to the console port. The console system is configured using a terminal or terminal emulator with session setting 9600. This should be setting, otherwise like when you are accessing the CLI, it will give you the the output will be not good, means the syntax it will be show that will be not supportable. It will show you the different means output during the time of configuration. So what are the steps? Login to the console via admin with the default password is EvoSend. If you are not able to access the device, please enter. It will ask for the new password, then you can type the new password. At the command prompt, enter wizard to view the current IP configuration. The current IP configuration you can see via using the this command. You can see the current configuration is 160.10. This is the default configuration of this, and this is the subnet mask. When you take the console, it gives you this prompt. You need to type the password. Welcome to ACS 8000 series. And this is the serial number of this device. Right? You need to type the viz command. Why we are typing the viz command? If we want to configure this device, we have to use the viz command. And to see the configuration. The device status is enabled, and here you can see this is the default configuration, and right. So here it will give us one option. Okay. So it's not there, but it gives a one option if you want to configure this device according to us. There is a DSCP, means you can say dynamic and static option. We need to choose the static, and we can enter the IP according to our requirement. So let me go down, and might be we have this option on this link. Okay. Yes, so you can see this is a viz command, and the default IP is this. When you will type the enter, it will ask for the IP method. You need to type the static. We want to configure it according to us. It was the previous IP, and this is the latest IP of this. This is a subnet mask, default gateway, LDAP is enabled or not. You can check it based on the requirement, MAC address, DNS. Your DNS will be primary or secondary, your domain name and the host name. These are the recommended things you need to mention. After that, if you want to configure any NTP, LDAP, anything, you can do. And in the last, it will ask you every configuration you have entered, that is true or not. Yes, it will restart. So security setting, you can check it, and network parameters, you can check it from here. This network, EvoSend, host name, DNS name, and static detail, you can see here as well. Port detail, you can see the port detail, means we have discussed how we can configure the port. You need to click on the enable, speed should be this, and all settings should be this. If you want to change the root password, you can change that. If you want to see the information about the serial number, about the version, firmware version, power supply, CPUs, everything you can check here. All are the serial port which are connected with this device. You can see here. So these are the basic things, and it's a very simple, like if you are configuring the Avosend, it's a very simple to manage, to configuration. Okay, so you can see it's a same simple guide, connectivity, about the connectivity. If you are facing any issue, you can log a case with vendor as well, and either you can drop a mail to support@westchipco.com.